To you I call, for you will surely hear me, O God. Turn your ear to me, hear my words. Guard me as the apple of your eye, and the shadow of your wings protect me. Glory be to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit.
As it was in the beginning,
is now, and ever shall be, world without end. Amen. To you I call, for you will surely hear me, O God. Turn your ear to me, hear my words. Guard me as the apple of your eye, and the shadow of your wings protect me. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, the love of God, and the communion of the Holy Spirit be with you all.
And with your spirit.
Welcome to Mass Monday in the 29th week of ordinary time. And we're offering this Mass this morning for the repose of the soul of Joseph McGuckie. Eternal rest grant unto him, O Lord, and let perpetual light shine upon him. May he rest in peace. Amen. Brothers and sisters, let us acknowledge our sins and so prepare ourselves to celebrate the sacred mysteries. I confess to Almighty God and to you, my brothers and sisters, that I have greatly sinned in my thoughts and in my words, in what I have done and in what I have failed to do, through my thoughts, through my most grievous fault. Therefore I ask Blessed Mary of the Virgin, all the angels and saints, and you, my brothers and sisters, to pray for me to the Lord our God. May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life. Lord, have mercy. Christ, have mercy. Lord, have mercy. Let us pray. Almighty and living God, grant that we may always conform our will to yours and serve your majesty and sincerity of heart. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, God, forever and ever. Amen.
Jesus, who was put to death for our sins.
A man in the crowd said to Jesus, "Master, tell my brother to give me a share of our inheritance." "My friend," he replied, "who appointed me your judge or the arbitrator of your claims?" Then he said to them, "Watch and be on your guard against avarice of any kind, for a man's life is not made secure by what he owns, even when he has more than he needs." Then he told them a parable. There was once a rich man who, having had a good harvest from his land, thought to himself, "What am I to do? I have not enough room to store my crops." And he said, "This is what I will do. I will pull down my barns and build bigger ones, and store all my grain and my goods in them. And I will say to my soul, 'My soul, you have plenty of good things laid by for many years to come. Take things easy, eat, drink, and have a good time.'" But God said to him, "Fool, this very night the demand will be made for your soul, and this hoard of yours, whose will it be then?" So it is when a man stores up treasure for himself in place of making himself rich in the sight of God. The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus.
In recent weeks, there have been two major sporting competitions going on. You probably haven't even noticed. The Rugby World Cup and the Cricket World Cup. Hours and hours of analysis is wasted. No, useful, I'm sure they'd say. Going into all these sports, all the decisions, all the passes made, all the drop catches, all that lava. But there's always one person on the field who gets the most criticism. The referee or the umpire. You can see why they wanted to bring in that television match official to look through replay after replay to make sure that they actually get the decision right. So I'm full of admiration for those who step up to take on the role of a judge in any situation. It is incredibly difficult to play the referee between those who are really only interested in their own problems or viewpoints. Indeed, the man in the Gospel only sees Jesus as a teacher with the authority to solve his problems. But Jesus vigorously rejects the man's request, not because he is insensitive to the injustice, but because his redemptive mission has very little to deal with our earthly desires. Yes, the Gospel and the teaching of Christ gives us a moral code to live by and a means by which we judge how to use these things of the passing world, but it is not a technical manual of how to gain worldly success. When people bring their domestic issues to the priest, we listen sympathetically, but probably we do not have the resources to deal with them. But when they ask us for prayer, for spiritual advice, intercession, or blessing, then we're back in our own wheelhouse. We might actually have something to offer. As Jesus promises us, "Seek ye first the kingdom of God and his righteousness, and then all these other things will be added on as well." Above all, our aim is eternal life with God in the communion of the saints. So the great challenge in the Christian life is to live as if each day is our last. To ask ourselves, what does God want me to do today? Who do I need to say sorry to today? By all means, we may use our money and possessions to have a comfortable life and to foster our interests and ambitions. But as Matthew 25 tells us, this should not be at the expense of the corporal works of mercy, for the sins of omission in how we treat others will form a large part of our judgment at the end of time.
Blessed are you, Lord God of all creation, for through your goodness we have received the bread we offer you, fruit of the earth and work of human hands, it will become for us the bread of life.
Blessed be God forever.
Blessed are you, Lord God of all creation, for through your goodness we have received the wine we offer you, fruit of the vine and work of human hands, it will become our spiritual drink.
Blessed be God forever.
Pray, my brothers and sisters, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father.
Lord, we accept the sacrifice at your hands for the praise and glory of his name, our good and holy Church.
Grant us, Lord, we pray, a sincere respect for your gifts, that through the purifying action of your grace we may be cleansed by the very mysteries we serve, through Christ our Lord. The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks. Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God, through Christ our Lord. In him you have been pleased to renew all things, giving us all a share in his fullness. For though he was in the form of God, he emptied himself, and by the blood of his cross brought peace to all creation. Therefore he has been exalted above all things, and to all who obey him has become the source of eternal salvation. And so with angels and archangels, with thrones and dominions, and with all the hosts and powers of heaven, we sing the hymn of your glory, as without end we acclaim.
Holy, holy, holy Lord, God of hosts, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest.
You are indeed holy, O Lord, and all you have created rightly gives you praise. For through your Son, our Lord Jesus Christ, by the power and working of the Holy Spirit, you give life to all things and make them holy, and you never cease to gather a people to yourself, so that from the rising of the sun to its setting, a pure sacrifice may be offered to your name. Therefore, Lord, we humbly implore you, by the same Spirit, graciously make holy these gifts we have brought to you for consecration, that they may become the body and blood of your Son, our Lord Jesus Christ, at whose command we celebrate these mysteries. For on the night he was betrayed, he himself took bread, and giving you thanks, he said the blessing, broke the bread and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it. For this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and giving you thanks, he said the blessing. He gave the chalice to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it. For this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many, for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith, save us, Saviour of the world.
For by your cross and resurrection, you have set us free.
Therefore, O Lord, as we celebrate the memorial of the saving passion of your Son, his wondrous resurrection and ascension into heaven, and as we look forward to his second coming, we offer you in thanksgiving this holy and living sacrifice. Look, we pray, upon the oblation of your Church, and recognizing the sacrificial victim by whose death you will to reconcile us to yourself, grant that we who are nourished by the body and blood of your Son and filled with his Holy Spirit may become one body, one Spirit of Christ. May he make of us an eternal offering to you, so that we may obtain an inheritance with your elect, especially with the most blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with blessed Joseph, her spouse, with your blessed apostles and glorious martyrs, with St. Mary Magdalene, St. Martha, St. Richard, and with all the saints on whose constant intercession in your presence, we rely for unfailing help. May this sacrifice of our reconciliation, we pray, O Lord, advance the peace and salvation of all the world. Be pleased to confirm in faith and charity your pilgrim church on earth, with your servant Francis, our Pope, and Richard, our Bishop, the order of bishops, all the clergy, and the entire people you have gained for your own. Listen graciously to the prayers of this family whom you have summoned before you. In your compassion, O merciful Father, gather to yourself all your children scattered throughout the world. To our departed brothers and sisters, and to all who are pleasing to you at their passing from this life, give kind admittance to your kingdom. There we hope to enjoy forever the fullness of your glory, through Christ our Lord, for whom you bestow on the world all that is good.
For all heaven with him and in him, O God Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours, forever and ever.
The Saviour's command, informed by divine teaching, we dare to say,
Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name.
Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Deliver us all, we pray, from every evil, graciously grant peace in our days. By the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Saviour, Jesus Christ.
For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours now.
Lord Jesus Christ, you said to your apostles, Peace I leave you, my peace I give you, look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant us peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign for ever and ever.
Amen.
Peace of the Lord be with you always.
Thank you.
Let us offer each other the sign of peace. Lamb of God,
you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, grant us peace.
Behold the Lamb of God, behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb. Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed. Behold the eyes of the Lord on those who fear him, who hope in his merciful love, to rescue their souls from death, to keep them alive in famine.
Let us pray. Grant, Lord, we pray, that benefiting from participation in heavenly things, we may be helped by what you give in this present age and prepared for the gifts that are eternal through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
So just a reminder that Mass tomorrow, Tuesday, is at 9 a.m. That's because I'm going to London for the St John's Association Mass at St George's Cathedral in Southwark. After that, Mass is Thursday at 6:30 in the evening. The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
And may Almighty God bless you, the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Go and announce the gospel of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Amen, 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 Maria.
Who's this one? Is it St. Therese?
No, St. Elizabeth of Holy.
Oh, she's got roses. Oh, okay. St. Elizabeth of Holy. Okay, but she's carrying roses, like
Yeah.